Hello, my beautiful Bitterroots, and welcome to my channel, and I'm going to continue with my declutter series. Now, I'm in my bedroom, I'm going to declutter my bedroom, but I still haven't uploaded my video from last spring when I did my spring declutter of my bedroom, so insert that declutter right here. Hello, my beautiful Bitterroots, and welcome to my channel. And today I'm in my bedroom, and I'm going to be just filming a quick declutter. I'm not going to go through the whole process. I'll just kind of show you what I want to do and then show you the after. But basically, I was in here folding my laundry, and I decided, I was looking at some clothes going, okay, I've lost more weight. Those clothes need to go. And this clothes needs to go. So this will be my third, get this, my third clothing declutter in the last 6 to 8 months. I finally decided to give up on these boots. Finally. I've been saving them for the day that my MS would get better to where I could wear heels again. I got rid of all my other heels. I had some beautiful pumps that I absolutely loved. And I just had to get rid of everything and go strictly to flats. And I was holding on to these because I'm like, these are a little more sturdy. You know, I should be able to walk in these just fine, right? You would think, well, my MS has been getting worse. So that means no more heels. So bye-bye boots. And I pulled out 3 pairs of jeans. I don't know if you guys remember, but when I first started my weight loss journey, I was wearing a size 24 pant, and then I decluttered my 22s, and now I'm decluttering out my 20s. So I've got 2 20s in here, and then I do have 1 18, but I have 2 pairs of 18s in my drawer. I have a skinny pair, and then I have a boot cut, so I don't need another boot cut jean. I pulled out a couple cardigans that were 2XL cardigans. This one's 1XL that I absolutely love, but it's just getting so big. And then I have a 2XL sweater here that made it through my last couple purges. And then here's an XL sweater or cardigan also that I'm like, well, it's warming up. I don't need these anymore. And by the time I'm able to wear them again, I'll be even smaller. So why am I holding on to them? Because now I'm wearing large for my top and 18 bottom. So yeah, why am I keeping these? So I'll show you kind of the areas I want to declutter again, because these are my problem areas. I am so very, very bad when it comes to organization. I can keep my house clean for the most part, but organizing certain areas that people don't see, that is a big issue for me. So last time I decluttered my bookshelf, and so I'll need to go in here, and because this is like the catch-all, everything just goes out onto my bookshelf. So all of this just needs to go. Like my earrings, I'm too lazy to put them away, so I just throw all my earrings in here, or my bracelets, or whatever, into this box. This bookshelf isn't as bad. I mean, it needs to be dusted like crazy because we live on a dirt road, and this is our lifelong battle is dust because we live on a dirt road. That's just how it is. But I've got some things in here that I just got to put away. This is for my candle thing that I'm filming, and these are all the duds that won't burn, and then these are the ones I burned up. So I'm saving them for my next filming next month, but I gotta find a new place for them. They shouldn't be out on the shelf. And pretty much everything else, I mean, is fine. I gotta find a new place for that. Yeah, I gotta declutter that. And then the next thing I gotta declutter, and you'll see on my TV that I am watching declutter videos on YouTube while I'm decluttering my bedroom. Funny. And then this corner, I cleaned it, but it just got stuffed with a bunch of stuff, like packing, mostly packing supplies. I gotta get all the packing stuff because I package and I mail stuff all the time. So I'm always running to my bubble wrap box, my box that has all the bubble wrap and my stash of, you know, envelopes and stuff. But then I've got white sheets there that I was planning on making a homemade projector, outdoor projector with my cell phone. It didn't work. It was like super blurry. So I just need to get those out in the garage for our garage sale and get everything else all put away, kind of deal. But I mean, everything else in my bedroom is pretty decent. Oh, except for this. This is my table, and it always gets just stuff all over on it. And then down there is mostly tubs of extras, and then I've got a bunch of stuff that needs to be filed. And then I'm going to take down all the old pictures that my kids drew on the walls, because this is where we display their artwork, is in our bedroom. But I'm going to take it down because we're planning on painting the whole place and just getting it ready to sell in the next... We want to try to have this place sold by 2020. So we got a lot of work to do in that time. Okay, quick update. I went through the bookshelf. I pulled some stuff out and I cleaned it all up. Organized it, made it look all better again. And then I did this bookshelf also, which is looking good. Organized all this. I went through and filed all that paperwork, but now I just need to dust that all off and then go through the bins that are back there. I have both of these bags that are completely open, so what I did, instead of storing them all up on top of my dresser, I decided to pack all my packing supplies in one of these. This is just gonna go underneath the bed, so it'll be out of the way, out of sight, and nobody will see it, but yet I will know exactly where it's at in my house. And oh, and then I found I was really, really, really into couponing, but then the lady I was getting my coupons from flaked on me. So all of these have probably been expired for way too long. Oh, July. Yeah, these expired July of last year. My couponing book. Can you believe that? July. See? That was June. I had ordered some more coupons from her, and then she decided she wasn't gonna send them. So that was the end of my couponing days, that I do not have to buy a single bottle of shampoo, toothpaste, or body wash for many years to come. Just saying it. And oh no, this is more. Oh no, no, no. Oh no. I was on vacation and most of this stuff expired. So see, I got 10 of these Smart Source and I had 10 Red Plum. Oh, that is sad. I'm just gonna have to throw that in the recycle bin. That is so sad, this whole thing. Oh, well, you know what? I'll just save this thing for Lissa for school. Oh, fuddy-duddy, oh well. Okay, now the look of my dresser. See, I'm watching more declutter. Watching declutter while I declutter. And now we're back. So now we're doing our fall declutter. I declutter my house 2 to 3 times a year. And so here we are, 6 months after my last one, and I am ready to declutter. So sorry if I look like crud. I got really dark circles going on. I am going through a rough patch right now, pain-wise, for multiple sclerosis, and I'm having to detox off my old meds to start a new pain med. So the detoxing has been hell, needless to say. I mean, I'm not puking or anything like that, you know, because it's non-addictive, but the problem is that because I'm not taking as many pain meds in a day than I normally take, I'm having to deal with the MS pain a lot. So much so that I have not been sleeping. I am extremely tired during the day. That kind of deal. So this too shall pass. This too shall pass. I just have to get past this next month and a half until I'm at my maintenance dose of the new pain med. So that's where I'm at. So let's start with a quick tour of my bedroom and problem areas that I always need to get a handle on. And I can never get a handle on. It's always an issue in these certain areas of my bedroom. So
let's go on.
as you know, I decluttered the bathroom not too long ago, so I don't need to do that. I decluttered that top two things. The bottom two, I'm currently decluttering. I do need to file all that stuff to this bookshelf. So this bookshelf has always been a catch-all. And as you can see, I've got more catch-all. I mean, it's just stuff that if I need to do something, gets put there. Everything just gets thrown there. So what I need to do is put stuff away immediately. I do need to go through my books again because Hastings is going out of business and I've been shopping at Hastings. I've been there twice this week, in this past week, buying books. So I need to just get out the stuff that I don't want, and the stuff that I haven't read, I need to pull out and read immediately and just get it out. And I keep my favorite authors. You know, all the Tracy Petersons, they stay for sure. And then pretty much the first three and a half rows of this are like my favorites. And then after that, it's just kind of so-sos. I would like to go through the closet and declutter it again. Since last fall, when I decluttered my wardrobe, I was still really good about keeping just a minimal amount of clothing. Before, when I did my declutter, this whole section was completely full. And our closet isn't super extremely big, and so my husband, did pretty good with keeping his clothes to a minimum also. So I would like to just go through here, and then I need to reorganize this and then get a lot of our blankets back up in there, and then our sheets kind of got all distorted, so I need to get that all fixed. We do not have a linen closet in our house at all. So, and then shoes need to be picked up off the floor and put on the rack, obviously. And then I need to go through the coats and all that stuff that's on that back rack and pull out my jackets that are too big for me. I've got this bookshelf, which again, it's another catch-all. So I just need to go through this. I want to pull out a lot of these magazines. I don't know why I keep magazines when I don't even look at them. So I need to go through them and just declutter all this also. So there's all that. And then there's a bunch of empty Birch boxes just tucked up in there. And then we go to the top, and we've got, this is my empties bin, and as you see, it's flowing right now. These are all empty glossy boxes, and that's an empty Allure box. So I'm going to actually be using these as Christmas gifts boxes and stuff this year. So these will be used and passed on. I just need to find a better solution for those. That's a popcorn tin that I've got random stuff just thrown in there that I need to go through and get rid of that. But yeah, ugly, 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 ugly. When we bought this house, previous owners decided to do stamping on the walls, and it's ugly, ugly, ugly. And we've lived here for 11 years, and we've never painted. That's one of our projects is gonna be painting this whole house. And then we get down to my dresser and Malachi's bid. And then balance balls definitely always stay. I pull them out when I do my exercises and stuff. So I want to go through my drawers. This whole pile here of all these books and the sleepers are going to go to my nephew, so that's not going to be here. Then we have all my sample boxes here. I'm not going to go through sample boxes. I mean, pretty much everything on this here is not going to go anywhere. I probably will put some stuff away that I've just kind of thrown up here. But oh, you know what? I see two things right here that I can get rid of. Whoops. So these are Avon's MARC brand. This is a solid fragrance pencil, and this is in Celebrate. And this one is in Very Sassy. I'm just going to declutter these right now, because the other one, I'm still having a hard time trying to get through it, and they drive me crazy, and they're tacky, and I don't like them. So I don't know why I'm keeping them. So these, I don't have a declutter box in here. I think I'm all out of declutter boxes. Anyway, so I guess the declutter box is going to be the bed. My little gripper thing. You never know when you're going to need that. But I've got blankets and then sheets. I did laundry, and so I need to fold up all this stuff, put away nice. And then this is just a little basket that has all of our totes in it. So every time we need a tote, I will grab one out of here or just grab the whole thing if I need totes and stuff. I do want to go through that chest. Let's tackle bookshelves. So this is my old phone case. So this is just going to go in the garbage because it's pretty dinged up. Here's the case to my current case. I don't need the case. These headphones can be decluttered. Ooh, I could still use that. With my favorite wipes. Love Comes Softly. Do I have this one? Book one. Love Comes Softly. I do have it. Okay. Well, this one could be decluttered because I do have a Love Comes Softly. Okay, declutter, which is probably why it was put up here. This I took out of the bathroom because it needed to go in the laundry room, and this is how far it went. This is a box of all my earrings that I just need to put away. Okay, top shelf done. These need to go with all my other shipping supplies. This needs to go with Lissa. That's Lissa's. Lissa likes these little variety puzzle things. They're going to go to her too. These are not my knockaround sunglasses in here. I have my other ones. My knockarounds are out in my car. So these obviously stay. I just got to clean everything up. Okay, so this is a bunch of headlamps. And when we did the Hiawatha Trail, they got really muddy, and I've been meaning to clean them. So this is where they stay because I'm so bad about that. My hair tie. Oh, this goes with the kids' school supplies. Bra inserts. Really? Really, Z? Really? All of this is all sunscreens. Whole thing is sunscreens. I'm going to declutter all of these little nail things because I don't like them. They don't stay on my nails. Okay, next shelf down, we've got a bunch of books that need to make their way into... This one goes in the other book shelf. These ones... these are little purple fairy lights. Then this is ornaments that I showed for my one declutter. What are you? Oh, I think this is that car handle. Oh, yeah. You know what? I'm going to pass this on. I'm going to see if somebody else may want this car handle. It was that steady thing that I did a review on. And it fit in my car, but it didn't fit in my husband's car. And that's where I need it, is in my husband's car, because it's down lower. Listen, Eli. Oh. Some more variety puzzles and games. The kids love that. So these are going to go with the kids pile. Sudoku, fill-ins, all that stuff gonna go with the kids. Then these ones I kept. I'm gonna peel the label on these, and then I'm gonna put some of my shampoo and conditioners that don't have pumps, because I prefer to work with a pump when I'm in the shower. It's just easier for me and my hands. With MS, I just have major issues with my hands. So these are going to be, I'm gonna do something with. I just haven't done it yet. I like historical fiction more than anything else, but I do love Francine Rivers. My favorite book of hers is this one. This is the most amazing, amazing book of all time. You need to read it if you haven't. It's a must. Absolute must. You know what? I'll put it in my to-read pile, and if I don't get to it by the end of the year, I will declutter it. In 6 months, if I don't read it by my spring declutter, I will declutter it out. I don't know. I don't read a whole lot of Gilbert Morris anymore. I'm kind of over that. Brides of Montclair. Oh, I loved this series, and I only have 3 and 4. Because I love this series, I guess I'll keep this. The proposal. I think I'll pass on that. I'm gonna pass on this. I want to read these. I haven't read them yet. These. You know what? I think I'm gonna just get rid of all these. Declutter. I do like Oak, Jeanette Oak, but I haven't watched One Breaks the Dawn, Gentle's Promise, Winter's Not Forever, Once Upon a Summer, Winds of Autumn. I don't have all of the things for this. Okay, the Bluebird and the Sparrow. I'm gonna declutter this. These I'll think on. I'll think on. Now I love Love Comes Softly series. The series stays forever. That's the best series ever. I also have all the movies to these too. Get rid of all of these. Okay, Heirloom Brides. I have read it. I don't think I'll read it again. Colorado. Did I read this? Okay, I have not read this one, so I will put this down here. Kansas Brides. I don't think I've read this one either. Actually, I'm pretty sure I probably haven't. I've read this one, so I'm going to declutter this one out. Okay, guys, for somebody who loves books, to declutter this much so far is pretty darn awesome. I mean, look at all that I'm getting rid of. I'm just trying to tell myself if I'm not going to read it a second time, then I should not keep it. Actually, you know what? I'm going to declutter this one also. I'm not going to reread this. I like historical fiction. I'm not going to reread that. I'm going to declutter that too. Aren't you guys proud of me? Aren't you guys proud of me? Look it. Okay, bookshelf is completely done, and I shifted some stuff around so that way every single book can actually breathe. Before, I had it so jam-packed in there that you really had to pull to get something out. So that's what my bookshelf looks like. And go from there. So this empty. This has no lid. This empty. This I'm actually going to declutter because I have a new one. This is a charger for a cell phone. And I mean, this does all right, but I have to charge it every single time now. So I'm just going to declutter this because I got a new one. So, books in here. What do I have in here that I can declutter? These are the kids' piggy banks. Yes, they're savers. Those definitely stay. Death and Yellowstone definitely stays. I love the Legend of the Firefish series. This one was sent to me for review purposes, so I cannot. I'm not allowed to pass it on or sell it or do anything like that because it's an advanced reader copy. The only other thing I could do is just throw it in the garbage. Death of a 6-foot teddy bear. Declutter. Get rid of it. Aaron Patterson series. I know him personally. He wrote on the inside of all of the books for me. So, he's the ex-husband of one of my friends. Let's just say that. The Shack stays. I actually promised that to my mom. These stay. These are good ones. I think Alyssa will enjoy those. Here's another Morris book. I'm going to get rid of that one since I got rid of the other one. Here's another Gilbert Morris one. I'll get rid of that. And Finders Keepers. I'm going to get rid of that. This is a very old book of poems. These Jan Karen series. I'm going to get rid of all of these. They're not really up my alley. So all of them are going to go. Oh my gosh. Oh, look who it is. Okay, wow, look at all those books I got rid of up there. That's awesome. Charisse! I love Brown Eyed Girl Charisse. She's amazing. Back to my declutter. Now I did my quick little shout out to Charisse. Hi, Charisse! I'm gonna be going back to Hastings again and again until they close, just so you know. So, I gotta make room. And anybody who knows me knows that I love the poem
footprints in the sand, so this always will always stay down there. And this is their little tithe thing, so every time they get money, they always put their 10% in a separate little piggy for the Lord. This is a Bible. It's got a dragonfly on it. I love dragonflies, so this Bible stays because it's my Bible. It's my Bible. Time, so I'm going to declutter that. Jesus Freaks by DC Talk. Keeping that. Max Licato. We got to definitely keep Max Licato stuff. We got quite a bit. The Resolution for Men. Keeping that. For sure. Okay, Discover Your Kids' Spiritual Gifts. Power of a Praying Wife. Revelation, a self-study guide. You know what? I'm going to get rid of this book. We don't need it. The Bait of Satan. Such a good devotional. Definitely, definitely, definitely suggest this, guys. Love is a Verb devotional by Gary Chapman. You know, there's 365 days of inspirationals. Love that. Season of Reflection. This is where you can read the Bible in the entire year. I'm so allergic to everything. Point Man Stays. It's another great one. The Power of a Positive Wife. A great, great book. Keeping that. Experiencing God. Another great book. Life Change for Couples. Great book. Experiencing God. Workbook. Keeping that. So, I didn't get rid of a whole lot in that one, but that's all right. My Project Candle and stuff, I have not been successful in using up a whole lot, so it's pretty much all I've used up besides the candle that's burning right now. Okay, this is an Amazon beauty box. Why am I keeping this box? There's nothing in it. Actually, I will put it aside for Christmas because I will put a box something in there. Oh, Charisse, I'm going to have to rewatch this. I hear you, but nothing's registering. My Wildflower book goes back. All of these things we're keeping because this is stuff that we use a lot. We love hiking to waterfalls. Then I have my Wildflower book. I have my Pacific Wildflower book. I got Hiking in Glacier and Yellowstone. And then I have my Rocks and Minerals guide. That all stays. 2008 fat and calorie carbohydrates thing. You know, I haven't even used it. Let's get rid of it. Goodbye. The Maker's Diet. If I follow any diet at all, it will be the Maker's Diet. This is what I follow the most closely of. This is amazing, amazing, amazing. And then Shopper's Guide, so that stays. A book about multiple sclerosis. And I know everything about multiple sclerosis, so do I need this book? You know, I think I got rid of all my other multiple sclerosis books, so I'm gonna keep that one for now. Dave Ramsey, Total Money Makeover, definite keep. This is amazing. How in the world? This is something that I had as a kid. And you know what? I'm just going to... Oh, see? Oh, this was given to me in 92 by my grandparents. I'm actually going to pass this on to my children. This is Montana Mining Ghost Towns. And we actually know Larry and Vivian. They are the ones that took the photos in this book. So, of all the ghost towns. So, we're keeping this just because we know the photographers personally. So, that's been decreased by a lot. And, of course, another footprints thing that stays. Mm-hmm. Just saying. Next one. Another variety puzzles and stuff. Send that off to the kids. Now, this is my old Bible. I don't use my old Bible. I use my new one. Don't use this Bible anymore. I don't know why I'm keeping it. Anyway, so albums, all that jazz. Oh, I lied. There is another multiple sclerosis book. There's this one, too. Multiple sclerosis, A New Journey. What do I have in here? Router and Jigs. That's all my husband's stuff. The Big Green Book of Recycled. Florists. Dinner is in the Jar. That one I'm keeping. Variety puzzles. Variety puzzles. Lots and lots of them. Notebook can go. Okay, so flowers A to Z. Buying, growing, cutting, and arranging. I do use these, refer to these books when I'm doing wedding flowers, so I guess I'll keep that. Flowers for the Home, I guess I'll keep that. It's all about the beads. I'm going to get rid of this book. Beading techniques. I can get rid of that. Creative beading. I'm going to keep this because I don't do a whole lot of this. So I'm going to keep that one. Ooh, Christmas one. Keeping that. Rings and things. Get rid of. Floral crafts. I'm going to keep that one. And then here we are to all my bead magazines. Let's go through all my bead magazines now, shall we? Bead and Button. Bead Style. Bead Style. Bead Style. Bead Style. Simply Beads. Bead Style. Bead Style. Oh my goodness. Lots of Bead Style. Birds and Blooms. Bead Style. Bead Style. Silpata. Sundance, Sundance. They're going to be recycled. I'm just going to get rid of all these. It's reduced by a lot. Kids pile. This goes in the garage sale. Do you see this, guys? I'm getting rid of 31 books. And I'm getting rid of 21 magazines. Okay, I think a lot of this stuff that I threw in this tin was actually supposed to be for garage sale. So I guess I had a garage sale thing in mind in here. I just forgot all about it. Okay. So that pile there is all going to the kids. This is all recycle. And then here's the bookshelf now. And then up there, I'm not going to do anything with that box because that's all my empties. And then these are all empty boxes. I'm just going to store them there for now. And then Christmas, I'm just going to start putting stuff in boxes and for Christmas instead of wrapping them up. Recycle those and just send them off to other people. Haha. Oh, this is the Darby Smart box. And I never did anything with it. Whoops. Never did anything with it. Okay, you know what? Since I did not touch it, it's been a year since I've had this. I have not touched it. I'm not going to obviously do anything with it. So that goes. Oh my gosh, okay. So I open up this chest and I'm bombarded by old t-shirts. You know how I kept all those t-shirts? Let me turn off this AC. You know how I kept all my old t-shirts to make doggy toys? Well, I still kept the remnants of them. So all of these are all gonna go. Bye-bye. Get rid of every single one of them, because if I don't, then they'll never get rid of, I'll never get rid of them. Look at all that. All of that. Okay, I was able to get all of our King sheet sets in here, and it still closes. So, woohoo! Do we need that king size blanket? We got a lighter one and we got our heavy ones. I'm gonna get rid of that king size blanket. Okay, so I pulled out 5 t-shirts, old t-shirts of my husband's. I left a couple older ones in there for when he does chores around the house and stuff like that. He doesn't need to keep all of them. That's a bag full of bubble wrap that I will use for shipping off whatever. But I finished out the closet. All the shoes were all put away. I organized up there, put all the blankets away. And then that, I pulled out a coat. I am keeping that coat and for the time being until I can buy a new one. I put away all the sheets that were in here, and of course I had a couple pins because I hang everything out in the line. So apparently I missed a couple when I was taking down the sheets. Getting rid of these necklace stands. I used to use them for all my shows and stuff, stuff like that. I do not use them anymore, so I'm just going to put them in the garage sale. And then here are the clothes that I pulled out. These ones, you'll see it. They were put aside to put in the garage and they didn't make it out to the garage, but they were in my earlier declutter. Excuse me. This is a sweater that I pulled out. I don't wear anymore. It's too big. Then I pulled out two shirts and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tanks out of the closet. Okay, so basically what I ended up just doing was getting rid of a bunch of skirts. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 skirts
And then this out of my drawers. I really don't have a whole lot in my drawers. I mean, this is like all my workout stuff. I do have some stuff I still need to put away. And like, this is my drawer for all my skirts. I definitely like the long skirts, the maxi skirts. Basically a whole basket of clothes I decluttered. And I forgot to show you that this coat is finally being retired. It's way too big for me. And then we're gonna get rid of that blanket. All that stuff is gonna get rid of. That's gonna go trash or whatever. But yep, that's all the stuff I'm getting out of the bedroom and all of that stuff. Okay, room is done. So that's my corner, I guess. As good as it's gonna get there. Bookshelf. That I need to find the lid to that, so that way I can store away all my sunscreens. But that's the bookshelf. This bookshelf is Dune. I did vacuum the dog bed, but it does need to be washed, as you can see. But I vacuumed the whole room. And that. So there's our room. Our room isn't nothing spectacular by no means. I want to build my own headboard and stuff, and I just haven't done that, so we're headboardless basically. But yeah, so that's our room. Yay. But it's done, and I can say that this part of the house is completely done. We got the bathroom, we got this bedroom. Now I need to declutter everywhere else in the house. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will see you in my next video.